glad to see that you all came and you all voted, right?
Yeah.
Cool. Quilters are good. We should be voting for a quilter.
Yes.
Don't you think, huh? Yay! This is like the biggest day in history. Yes. Oh my gosh, it's just so much fun. Anyhow, we're going back to old times. We're going back to Mary Poppins. That's old times, huh?
Yeah.
Any of you Mary Poppins? Do you know the song, Let's Go Fly a Kite?
Yes.
Do you want to sing it or do you just want to think about it? Okay, who can lead it? Let's go fly a kite up to the highest height. Let's go fly a kite and send it soaring up to the atmosphere, up where the air is clear. Let's go fly a kite. Some of you guys. Some of you didn't know the words.
We did
pretty good. Oh.
She's flying a kite. She's trying to find her kite, Kylie.
Oh. Kylie, oh my goodness. Oh, that's so cute. We'll show you. So, what do you think the name of the quilt is? That was a lead-in. Go fly a kite, of course. Okay, you ready?
Yes.
It is really a cute quilt. Okay, I want you to make lots of noise. Let's see if I can do this on my walker. I'm just so excited. I'm showing it off.
Woo!
Woo! Flying kite quilt. And the first one. Ta-da! Aw. So turn it around and show everybody. It's very scrappy, very, very scrappy. And this one looks so cozy and inviting, but what's really fun, Teresa showed Kylie, we'll show you later. So we named this little patch Kylie's Kite. And this is it right here. This is Flying Kite. And then it's from a 5-inch charm pack, 5-inch charm pack, easy. And then the second patch in it is a little 4-patch, also from a charm pack. So it's easy, just charm packs and background fabric, and that's it. And these are nice big blocks, and I love the binding on this. This is really cute. And Teresa, Gail did this one. Show Gail, make lots of noise. Aww, very, very pretty. Really fun, nice background. Oh, we must have had a special on the backing fabric. Yeah. Ah.
Sorry.
And this one is set together with a lattice. And so now you can see the block. It's actually made in 4/4. Okay, let's divide it like this. 2 kites, 2 4-patch. That's 1/4, and then 4 of them together. The 4-patch meets in the middle. This is great. Long arm quilting. It looks really charming. And then if you don't like all of that mushy look of everything put together, a lattice.
I like that. Yeah.
You like it? Do you like it?
Yeah.
And this is the best part. Look at the little cornerstones. They are made from the cutaways of the kite. So you don't have to buy extra fabric. We love that, don't we? So I really love this peachy kind of color. So beautiful. And show the back.
It's
the same. Where did you get that fabric, Teresa? And whose quilt is that?
That is, I made that quilt.
You made that quilt, Teresa's. Okay, let's see. We should show the backing first. Look how cute that is.
The back. Dirty.
The quilting is charming. Look at that. That is very, very sweet. It's there. Isn't it beautiful? Just beautiful, hand-guided. So you could get hand-guided long-arm quilting, or you could get edge-to-edge, and it's kind of hard to tell on edge-to-edge. Show the front and go, ooh. So this is Sue's quilt, and what I like about Sue's quilt is that she was able to get a charm pack full of all really bright colors. Mm-hmm. And when you're selecting a charm pack, you want to make sure you don't have a lot of backgrounds mixed in your charm pack, because I know mine is coming up and I'll show you why. But anyhow, this one is all the beautiful, bright, small scale prints, medium, adorable. And then if you want to take an extra little kite, you can put it right in the very corners. Binding, lattice, I'm sorry, border around the outside edge. And that's just a little crib quilt, right? Yes. Two charm packs to make that size quilt. Two charm packs. And I know where you can get some great deals on charm packs. This one is, this is the same. This is also two charm packs. And who did this one? Teresa did. See, I haven't been around here very much. I don't know who's making these quilts. That is very nice. And Teresa also was very fortunate to have a lot of bright, deeper colors. Just when you get into something like this, it's a little hard to work with, but you need every single square in your charm pack, so you can't leave anything out. Mm. Write that down. Remember that.
You have four left.
Oh, yeah. And then, oh, you have four left. And then there's the little kite in the corners as well. And look at the backing on the next one. It's really cute. Ah, and
I made that.
Teresa made this one too. That's what she's been doing in my absence, just making quilts, huh?
Because you haven't been here, she's been having to slave over.
I know, but I made one of them in the stack. I keep on hoping that it shows up. It's going to show up. That's really cute. So I think this one is it, because I recognize the lattice. Okay, it is. I made a decision, Teresa.
Okay.
I want you to turn it the other way around.
You mean
yes.
This to be the top?
Yeah, this is going to be the top, because what I did was I put all of my favorite pieces on the top. I used everything that I really, really liked, and I will tell you, I had a great time sewing this quilt. I totally enjoyed it. I got into trouble when I got to the very last block, and I believe if you have a block in your quilt that you don't really like, you put it on the bottom. And that's what I did. And this was all of the weakest colors that I had left. And I had to use it or it wouldn't have been a finished quilt. Yeah. So anyhow, you didn't notice it, did you?
No.
You put it on the bottom and nobody notices. That's the rule. Okay. Okay, this is Patty's quilt. Aww. Those are really pretty colors too. The colors are really pretty. It does, yeah. A lot of really sweet pieces. Yeah, Patty's been traveling so much and she's leaving again today. Patty's been, yeah, she's been staying with me, helping me out too. She loved doing it. Yeah, yeah, she's really enjoyed making all the quilts. All right, crib quilt, two charm packs, and Christmas! This Marianne? This Marianne? Whoa, Marianne, look at that. Wow. That is really cool. Now, did you cut all the black and with the gold? Did you cut the?
I didn't have charm packs, I just used yardage.
You used yardage, okay, and that has a completely different look. Really, really fun. That's really fun quilting too. I have a feeling Marianne took a teacher training class in Paducah with Sue, and this was one of your projects. Mm-hmm. I take
no,
it.
No. Nope.
Teresa just gave it to you. See, if Teresa gives you something, you can get recognition really fast here in class. So accept it and do it, huh? Whoa! That was it.
That's it.
Is that a good show? All right, so everybody's going to go fly kite. Are you going to put one up on the board? Yeah, put one up on the board. Okay, don't look at me. I'm going to get to my chair. But I'm doing so good, huh?
Yes, you are.
Okay, So like I could just like take the walker and throw it away. Uh-uh. Just flip it out of the way. See if I can get to my sewing machine. I will tell you, in this recovery, my sewing machine has been my savior. It really has. Because I can slide up and I could sew. And now I'm going to make sure I've been sitting on my wheelchair and I can lock it in place. But this chair has wheels on it. So let me catch up. Okay, so you have your pattern. It's really nice. Let's put it right here. Flying Kite Quilt. So fun. And inside you have your yardage. You're going to start with just, you can do a crib or you can do a lap. Two charm packs for a crib. And how many for a lap?
Three to four.
Four.
Four. Oh. And let me tell you, four. And if you get a layer cake and cut it into fours, that is so easy to do. Then you have four pieces right off the bat that are similar, that are all alike. So it works really good. It's a lot of fun to just get a layer cake or just charm packs. And just keep on going. So go to page four. And we're going to start out with our four patch. This is a fun, fun way of doing a little four patch. You just take your one of your mediums. Divide your stack right away. Your charm pack into a stack of mediums and darks. The mediums are for your four patch, the darks are for your kite. And so this one is just a really good medium, and then you're going to take your background, cut it into 5-inch pieces, and put them right sides together. Whoop! Pretty good. All right, so just line up the outside edges. That's so much fun just to use a charm pack. Okay, and a ruler, the 6 by 12 ruler is a really good one. Just take and line up 2.5 along the left edge, and then just mark a line down the middle. And I found out that that line, the 2.5-inch line, should run along the outside edge because you want to divide this into two equal pieces. That's easy. That's a start, right? Mm-hmm. And you might as well just make a whole bunch of them. For the crib quilt, you need how many?
24.
And for the lap, you need to have 48. So you might as well just stack them up. I really like my quarter-inch foot. It is a perfect quarter of an inch. Okay, just put your quarter-inch foot, the edge of your foot on the line or whatever you have on the line. I have my sew straight on here, but we could do it like this. See this line right here on your sew straight? You could line up the line that you just drew with this line on the sew straight. And so when you stitch, then your stitching is 1/4 inch away. So you can just keep that line along there and you'll see that the stitching line is going to come right out here. So if you don't want to mark, you don't have to mark. That's even better, huh? Okay, so now you've got one line. Just go ahead and cut your threads and just turn it around, and you're going to repeat. So put your quarter inch, put your foot. What's that? You mean, does the book say that? I looked at the book, Orion. When in doubt, look at the book. Look at the book. Okay, so, yep, right? That was easy. And so right now, I would suggest that you go ahead and measure this and make sure that the distance from one stitching to the other is 1/2 inch. If you measure right now, but just measure it so you're sure. Okay, so then you're just going to take it and cut it right down through the middle. What do you think? Have you ever worked with this on doing these charm packs? No. Doing quarter inch, you're going to love the next step. Okay, so just take it. And where did Teresa go? Hello, Care. What's that? She'll be right back. Well, you could step in. She's coming. Okay. You just set the seam with the medium on top, open and press the seam towards the medium. So now I'll let Teresa go ahead and do that. Ta-da! So I, yeah, I think I'm you. I use these nails, huh? Okay, so now I'm on step 6. So let's just take the two pieces and you're going to flip them right sides together and lock them. And if it lays flat, when you put them right sides together, this has to lay flat. If it feels bumpy, it's not locked. Take my word for it. Even if you're off like a 16th of an inch, you'll feel that bump. Okay, so line up like this. Again, you need to have your 2.5-inch line. And up at the top of number 8, step 8, page 5. And now you draw another line. Okay, this is where it gets tricky, Orion. I know what you were thinking about. So take a look at the picture on 9. Because we're not going to sew on both sides of that line. We want to make them the same. Ah, you see? And if you want, circle that. If you're going to make a mistake, that could be the spot. That could be the spot because you're just getting so good in that. You know, you're just boogieing right along. Okay, so the seam is going up. So make sure you just hold that seam flat. Okay, along there, and then just cut and pick it up and move it to that raw edge, clear on the right, okay? So that looks a little different. We haven't done that before, right? Ooh, but wait till you open it up. Okay. We're good. Okay. Come on, I need you to lift up. Okay. So now we're going to just cut it right on the line. Okay. This is the magic. I should have a magic hat on today instead of red, white, and blue. Ready? Ta-da! Ooh! Ready? Ta-da! Is that cool? That's very cool. That's very, very cool. I love it. She said, how did you ever figure that out? I know. We actually did it on one of the autumn patterns a while back. It was really fun. Okay, so you want to just open up this four patch. And this is that magical four patch. And you just mush it right in the middle. And whenever I open these up, I kind of like open them pretty forceful. And you just push the top to the right. Push, that goes down, bottom to the left, and it pops open. Eric, were you so close on that they saw it? And just mush it good. And there, okay, so now they lay totally flat on the back. And if you haven't figured this out yet, the reason that we really like to do that mushing and swirling on the back is because now when you put these together, no matter how you do it, they will always go in opposite directions and they will always lock. So that's why you really want to learn that technique and you can get that get it in there. Okay, so now are we good? You're going to press these? Yeah, I love Margaret. She's still amazed.
I am.
Where have you been, girl? Yeah, we love this. Okay, so that's your four patch. Pretty easy, lots of fun. Look at the little kite. So cute, coming up. Okay, so now remember you sorted your mediums for your four patch and now you need your darks. Your darks, and here's your little 5-inch square. And I'm looking, is there a little, yep, fussy cut. Okay, so be careful on this because Patty went and did all of these wrong. I think it'd be really good if you put it at point. What do you think? It shows right in the beginning, it shows it A straight on. Okay, we'll start straight on, but then we have to put it at point. So we're just going to take one corner. This is a 2.5 inch fussy cut. If you don't have a 2.5 inch fussy cut, all you're going to do is mark up 2.5 inches on two sides. But if you put the fussy cut ruler there, then you just do a little tick mark there and a little tick mark there. Good? Yes. Okay, so you can see them. So now put them on point. I don't know what Patty was doing, but anyhow, she didn't do it right. Okay, so I want you to look at the picture right beside number 2, because these are the cuts that you want to make. We're going into the point right there, into the point. So you put your edge of your ruler at 2.5 and up in the point, okay? And then just cut. Don't save it. Don't throw these away. Save them. Very valuable. Okay, now you go to the point again and the 2.5 inch line, and you cut, and you have a
kite.
Cool. Cool. So while you're while we're looking at the pattern, these little triangles that you discarded are cut into the cornerstones. They're cut at 1 5/8, and the reason is that's all you can get out of this little piece. Okay, so let's just put 1 5/8. There's 1 5/8. 1 5/8 to make a square. So when you cut them, ta-da! And along here, and that's your cornerstone. And these you can get rid of! But aren't they cute? They're just really cute.
Yeah.
Cute little cornerstones. Okay, so now we've got the kite cut. And this is the tricky part too. This is our background. These are going to go on the sides to make the kite. But you need, if you do a 6-inch strip and cut them into 3-inch rectangles, that's what your picture shows. It's a 6-inch strip cut into 3-inch rectangles. Just leave your fabric folded. These are those mirror image guys. They'll get you every time. I know a lot of times people, whenever I'm working, you know, they're all efficient. So they take everything. They fold every piece right side up. Uh-uh. Leave these wrong sides together. They're mirror image. Just take your ruler and cut them on one diagonal. Ta-da! And actually, 1/2 is enough for a kite. Don't take the top 2, take 1/2. Okay, and so now you're going to just turn it like this. Let me lay it out for you. Open them up, doo-doo, and doo-doo. And when you look, they make a square. Can you see the square? And I have done this so many times. You have to watch for the straight of the grain. It has to be in the outside. It's very, very tricky to not do that. This is the straight of the grain here. This is the straight of the grain here. You'll know because this stretches. So you need to get your straight of your grain all around the outside edge. Good? Okay, and so this is what I teach whenever I teach large groups. I've learned. You take the right stack and you set it aside. Don't even look at it. Okay? So take your whole right stack and you would have all these pieces stacked up. So then when you flip this right sides together, you've got the cutest little tip hanging out there. See this? Right at the top. And look at this, long hanging out in the bottom, all right? Ta-da, ta-da. We must have done this patch before. What was the last one that you did this on? Kylie's kite?
Yeah.
On Kylie's kite?
Yeah,
at a retreat. Orion and I did the original Kylie's Kite, and we were working late, and Teresa, his wife, kept on calling and saying, come home for dinner, come on for, we'll come home, I'll come home, he said, after one more patch. And we were moving so fast that I left some of the backgrounds I had wrong side up. Is that the first one we did? I think that is the first one we did. I think that's the first one we did. And it's really fun with Kylie's Kite. And then Orion and I said, hey, let's call this Kylie's Kite. Well, we sewed the blocks together and some of the backgrounds were wrong side up. And I was bummed. I didn't care, but I guess before I got back the next morning, Orion made Teresa take out all the wrong side up pieces and replace them. Didn't she? You did it.
The helper bee.
Yeah. Okay, so you've got the left side. So now you're going to take your background, just open and press it.
To the background?
So that your seam is behind the background. And see how this lines up pretty good along the top. And yes, you have to cut off your tip. We've got to turn the page. Okay, this is kind of tricky. Some people need to really, you need to really watch this. At step number 8, on page 8, it says trim your tip. And the best way to trim it is to just line up your ruler with the whole long side and just cut it off.
Okay.
It's a good one. Okay, you've got to cut it off. If you don't, you'll find out in the next step, because you can't take this piece and make it fit along there. Good. Okay, so just flip it right sides together. You know what? We're nearly done with the two steps. I love it. Okay, and now finally I get to show you my cool purple, little purple stripe, because when I sat down at AccuQuilt last Friday, this was in place. And I've fallen in love with this strip, with the sew straight and the lines, and then this little purple gives a ridge that your fabric just goes do, follows right along there. And when you sew, be sure and say that do. It helps. Okay. Whoops, let me get it lined up. Really?
Yeah.
One of my strips, one of my little things hanging out. It's just hanging around. Okay, so now just like you've got the tip at the top, the little tip, you got a long tip at the bottom. That's what it looks like on the back side. Just take the background, open, press it, make sure you go right into that bottom. And you just do it like that. Is it pretty?
Yeah.
Oh, I love it. Okay, so you get to press it. And now we have a new tool. Oh, the second one you press toward the kite. Thank you. I forgot to read it. I remember that. It's very important.
So the first one is away from the kite. The second one is...
Yeah, and look at that great picture. We worked really hard. I remember Merritt had to draw that picture. Beside number 12.
Yeah.
Do you see it?
Yeah.
Circle it. I forgot. I've done a number of quilts since then, but I forgot that one. Thank you, Teresa. Okay, and now do we have a ruler? Oh, it's right on top. Okay, so Invisigrip on the back of, it's really, we call it the 4.5-inch on point ruler, but it's really a kite ruler. So you can see it's unique. Right up here is where where it's really critical. Right here. Doo-doo, look at that.
Huh? We want to have a bow.
A bow, look at that. Okay, new turnable. I have been struggling with my turnables because some of them have been getting warped and they're not turning and things. And I was really frustrated when I went to Riley Blake over the summer. They gave us this new rotating mat. It's by Sue Daly. And it's really good. I really like it. It really goes a lot nicer than some of them. And so now you have to very carefully place this ruler on the lines. Let me show. Okay, right here is the most critical part. You want to make sure you have your point lined up, and it's going to just line up at the other two sides. Good. Okay, now I'm just going to turn it around. So I always like to start at the bottom. I'm not sure why, but you don't have to pick up your ruler. You just turn it if you want. You could have done two sides and just keep on turning it. And I'm going really slow, but you can get faster and faster. What do you think? Now, very nice, huh?
Yes.
Very, very nice. See the point up there? You show it, Eric. You can go in real close. So it's nice up there. Is that nice? Are you impressed, Margaret?
Yes, I am.
She's impressed.
Definitely. All three Margarets are impressed.
How many? Yeah, Margaret.
Margaret. There's three of us.
Three, all in the front row. Does that mean all Margarets sit in the front row?
We're impressed.
You're impressed. You're impressed. Okay. So that's really cool. I really like it. Okay, so now we have the two units made. That's all you got to know. Simple, simple. Okay, so now we're just going to set that aside. I like the texture on this, too. That's really, really nice. Okay, so Teresa did these ahead of time. And it's best, I think, if you take similar values. Like any of these, we could use across from that. Let's go this way. You like the plaid? Or you like the polka dot? I like the plaid. You could do two together like this. Or especially if you do a layer cake, you will always have two alike. And putting similar pieces or same pieces cuts down on the real scrappy look. You don't feel so all that stuff. But between these two, the one that's there, I really like. This one, it's kind of lighter.
Yeah.
No, doesn't look good, huh?
I like the other one.
You like that one?
Yeah.
Okay, well, let's audition.
No.
We had the right one the first time?
Yes.
Okay, that's cool. That's cool. Okay, so now you're going to turn all of these into little quarters. And you always have two four-patch alike. And I think, again, too, it also helps to cut down the distraction. How's that?
Mm-hmm.
I like that.
Yep.
And see, that's the little turquoise. Now watch. Then you start to lose on this one, huh?
No.
But you're going to have to use it sometime.
Yeah.
Okay, let's...
Maybe with the bright red.
Tomorrow. Or... You like... Wait, what do you like this one? Be aware of using all your favorites first. And where would that block go?
On the top.
On the bottom. I like that.
Uh-huh.
I really like that. Okay. So now I laid it out. Let me just turn it so it's the same as your little pattern. So you just see that going down. Good?
Yes.
Flip it.
Okay.
And you don't have anything to match right now.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing to match. You're just going to go right down along there. Ah, look, Teresa's already going to start getting them up there. Thank Thank you. So you guys can look at that while she's putting them up. Those are really pretty.
They're going to watch you.
Yeah, no, they're going to watch you. So quarter inch, keep them all lined up. And see, the reason that you really want to have a four patch exactly 4.5 inches, then it will go together with the kite, which you cut using your ruler, so they'll all work. So, ta-da! Very pretty. Okay, so don't clip them apart, just open them up like so. Just turn them and flip them right sides together. Top seam up, underneath seam down. Turn it.
Oh, they were tying the trees, I think.
You got me scared because I was looking at the picture to make sure. Huh? So what do you think about this pattern?
I like it.
It's really fun. It is very, very fun. And this right here, you're going to lock, put the top seam up, the underneath seam down, get that all lined up, pull it so it's lined. This seam is going to lay flat, and just zip it along. Let me see. Oh, look at the orange lattice. Whoa. What is coral. Coral lattice. That sounds a lot better, doesn't it? Thank you. I just bought a coral sweater. Now I'll know it's coral. That is really pretty. Okay, so this little thread right here, in the very center, we're going to swirl it. But the way I assembly line sewed it, you've got to take your scissors and cut a snip right there. And then just, oh, thank you. It looks like you just gave it all to me. And just, again, top to the right, down, left, and up. Swing that baby around there. Get that finger and mush it good. And so when you press it, it all lays really flat. Oh, look, Teresa. So that's the size of the block when you put four together.
Yeah, it's right.
Yeah, she already did. Here, you, all you're going to do is press that one. Okay, and so when you put these together, it's exactly the same thing. Let's do it this way. So you lay out four and turn them, and they're sewn exactly the same way so that you can, again, just mush that little centerpiece, push that up, and it is truly amazing how when you look at these, all these seams go in opposite directions. They all lock together. It's just really fun. All you got to do is follow the book. Very good. So then you see on page 10, you see Sue's that without lattice. And then Teresa's putting the lattice together. I really like that. What do you think? It's nice with lattice. It really sets it apart, and you can get those little squares. Oh, here, you want this little square? It won't stand out so good, but oh, look, she's got them all ready. Good. So the crib is 3x6, and the lap is on page 12. Did I say two by six? 2x3. 2 times 3 is 6. And then the lap is on page 12. And it shows you can do it just laying out with or without lattice. And it's just really fun. And then on page 14, it shows taking your extra kites. Teresa said you have four left in your charm pack. So you could put those in the corners. And there it is right on page 14. Very nice pattern. Merritt did a good job, huh?
Yeah.
Looks really, really good and nice and easy. So, you have any questions? just go cheer. Oh my gosh, look at that. We did it in only 40 minutes. It's very, very fun. Yay, it's so fun. Do you want to ask any questions? Yes, Marianne.
If you don't use this sachet, when your kites come together, four kites,
yes.
There's like 24 layers of fabric in that center.
Ooh.
How do you get it down without a rubber mallet?
You get a rubber mallet. You really whack it good. You know,
it's only 16, Marianne.
What? Where did you get 24? You know what? That's why I selected putting the lattice in, so that I didn't have so many seams in one spot, I thought. And also, I just really liked the color. I thought that was fun to put in there. So it looks really good. Oh. What did you say, Orion?
So there's a new, it's not wood, but like a wood, it's a rolling pin.
Uh-huh.
That's a rolling
like
pin.
A roller.
Yeah, and by Clover.
Uh-huh.
A little small one. You'll have a next block party.
Whoa. The new tool. We love new tools. Any other questions? Yes. Kylie's kite.
Everything went perfectly. If I tried to eyeball it, yeah, it didn't work.
It does. Yeah. Okay, so she said that when she measured that quarter inch tip perfectly, and also whenever I have a lot of thickness, I always use that jumper scrap, just a scrap to start, and I'm holding on to my jumper scrap as I'm starting to sew into the next piece where it's really thick. And then it doesn't jump it. Did you bring something?
Oh no, we're gonna share, aren't we?
We're gonna share, but we had Kylie's Kylie's picture.
Oh, do you have Kylie's picture? But
Kylie's
you have to come this way, right?
Sure.
Where? Okay. Kylie's kite.
What do I do? Or you go down there now?
Okay.
You can do it from right there.
Yeah.
You go.
Okay. You can do it from here. She said.
Tilt it up.
Okay. Oh, that was the boot. Okay, so I want to read what it says. Can you catch this deal? Flash sale, buy now. Oh, this is Kylie's race. How many laps did she do? Oh.
So if we don't buy the deal,
so
can
it's
we
written
just
as
donate?
You wrote it, Eleanor, so yeah. You have to pretend you know what you're doing.
So can we just
the race
donate?
Is on Thursday.
Can we just donate?
We don't know how much is does everybody
everything is 50% off. That little mm-hmm. thing is 50% off, and then you're donating $2 to the run.
How cool. How come I had to donate $1 a lap? Because I'm a grandma.
That's the privilege of being a grandma.
I'm the grandma.
Yeah, that's why. So I was just wondering if we didn't want to buy that package, could we just donate if we wanted to donate to it?
You can, and I can give you the link if you would really like to do that.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. That's really, really cool. So you're going to get... So she's practicing right there.
So last time she did the most laps. And
yeah, I remember.
She did raise the most money in her whole school.
Cool.
And she wanted all these prizes. So, you know, we did this deal last year. And then when it came down to the prizes, she gave them all away to her class. And I was like, wait, wasn't today? She's like, yeah, but no one got any prizes. So, and they just, they have that big, huge award ceremony, and she got them all. So, anyway.
Okay.
They're doing it different this time. So, now it's just for the class. So, now it's to get them, their, like, prize is like a pizza party. So
I want to tell you the inside story. This is what Kylie said about the race. He said she did the most laps. Kylie said, My daddy was beside me, and I was tired, and I wanted to stop. But my daddy kept on saying, come on, you can do it. One more lap, one more lap. And I had to keep on running. We train our kids, huh, Margaret?
When my grandson did that in school, he got a dollar for all their jumping. The only thing was, they let him rest.
Oh.
And then they started jumping again, so we owed him.
So the parents had to give a lot of money, and grandparents have to do a lot of money.
It was more than we expected.
Oh, that's really cool. Well, when I got the email, I thought the race was that day. I didn't know the date. I'm home trying to get better. I'm not up on everything.
You have a special guest from Ireland.
A special guest? Pardon me? Thank you. Oh! So, it was so fun on this historical day. So, you go! Fly a kite!